Everyone, it's Roberta. I'm back. Trying to get a second video and card done today. I have this piece of cracker box that I had spritzed with my glycerin water, and then I put it through my Big Kick with an embossing folder of swirls. And I found an image online and printed this out, a water lily. Or a lotus flower, and so I want to color it. I was going to use some inks for this. I was going to use patina and China blue mixed together to do this piece, to paint this one, and I'll probably do gesso on it first, my De La Rowney gesso. And this is going to be the card base. So, go ahead and get this real quick. And I want to keep this, so I'm going to move this out of the way. And my window is open, so you're going to be hearing dogs barking and the airplanes from CVG Airport. They fly overhead. I live in Florence, Kentucky, and it's only about a 15-minute drive from the airport, so when they fly overhead, it doesn't take long to get to our airspace, so you hear them. They're kind of loud. And I'm going to use my fingers to move this gesso and the paint around. There's a neighbor across the way that the dog just barks and barks and barks all the time. And then when the owner comes home, she talks to the dog in this really high-pitched voice to get it all excited, and then it just starts barking and yapping even more. I love dogs, but it can be annoying for neighbors when the dog is just barking a lot like that. I mean a lot. I'm not talking about just here and there. It's every day. So now I'm going to mix these two colors. I'm trying to see if I can get a look of water, which this is not the right color, so I'm going to add some blue. I like it though. I think it's pretty. I just want to add a little bit of blue. Oops. That put out the watery part of the paint. Don't want too much of the blue in there. Let's see if I can move this around. Okay. Excuse me. I need to put down a little bit more. I think it kind of is wiping some of that away now. Sometimes it's better to let something dry, and sometimes it's not. So sometimes it's hard to know, but I just have fun playing around. So I'm going to let this dry, and I'll be back. I got to clean my fingers. Okay, I'm back. Not liking the way that this is colored, so I just want to try to remove some of the paint, give it a distressed kind of a look. And the paint seems to have dried, but I can keep working it. And if it doesn't turn out the way I want, then I just won't use it. I just like trying new things. All the cards being same old, easy peasy, made the same way. Kind of gets boring to me. I like the difference of things, the uniqueness. It is pulling up some of the paint here and there. I like that much better. And I did have the manila colored card, but just not really feeling it. It doesn't, to me, it doesn't look good against that, although that I think looks better. So I put this one away. Let's stick with this one. And I also want to cut this down so that it will fit. Put that aside and just start painting this. My water brush, I never fill it with water, but it always has water because I wash it off in water and it kind of sucks water up into the barrel. I mean, not really in the barrel, but enough that when I'm trying to use it, it always has water. You can see there's nothing in the barrel. Totally empty. And yet it's always wet. Okay, now this color, I want to try to work it so the color is going to go together, and that does look pretty good together, so that's good. And I don't think I need that color anymore. That was Heavenly Blue of the Close to My Heart. I'm not really sure what color the lotus plant is. I just color things the way that I want to color them. This color is gray flannel. And that's the color I'm going to color the centerpiece here. It looks like a greenish gray kind of a color. I do want to use a pink color, and I'm going to go ahead and go back to the Pretty in Pink from Stampin' Up. I just want to get these little tiny bits here, and probably I should do the yellow of the lotus flower first, so I'll do that in a minute. If I do the pink, it'll end up blending in when I do the yellow. I burnt my thumb really bad. I believe it was Friday, Thursday or Friday. You can barely see. There's this little bit here. Let me put my light on. I totally forgot about the light. This little mark here on my thumb, it had been steam burned. And so I put mustard all over and left it on for about 4 hours because it kept stinging really bad. And it would have been a third degree burn with huge blisters, but because I used the mustard it just has this little bit which is gone. And then I did the same thing yesterday on my rice cooker, and this here, that would have also been a third degree, but I kept the mustard. Mustard is amazing for treating burns. Amazing. My daughter Nicole is the one who taught me that. She is self-taught herself homeopathy and has done a lot of research trying to figure out healthy ways of treating medical issues. And burns is one. I burn myself when I cook. I haven't done it a lot for a long time, but this last week I have. I don't know why. This one was when it was July 4th, I remember. I had decided I wanted a fried hot dog. I don't ever eat hot dogs, so I just wanted a fried hot dog. And had just bought some. And so I had dropped it into the pan, and I didn't intend to drop it. My fingers let go because of the carpal tunnel, and it just kind of dropped. And it splattered in the grease that was in the pan. Not there was much, but I had just re-seasoned my cast iron skillet. And so there was a bit of grease, and that just splattered right up and got my thumb. And then this was from a rice cooker. I was cooking a chicken. And when I opened the lid, I wasn't paying attention to the steam that would be coming out. I think I need some green on these parts here, too, so I need to pull my green out. But anyway, mustard is how I treated my burns. And I always keep a squeeze bottle in the fridge. And a squeeze bottle is nice because you don't have to worry about spinning it out or anything. You just squeeze it, and it's nice and cold. You just squeeze it right onto the burn. And it's not to say that it's not going to still sting and burn, because it does. It hurts really bad. But you just keep it on, and even don't take it off. You let it dry, like it creates a seal, and it keeps the air from getting to the burn, and so it doesn't sting as much. And you can always put some fresh on over it, because the cold mustard will be a relief to the burning sensation. But you can take it off for about 4 or 5 hours. And then if it starts stinging again, you just put some more back on. It works great. And it's cheap. Yeah, you don't have to run to the ER or the doctor. You don't have to worry about expensive ointments or anything like that. It's just cheap old mustard and a squeeze bottle from the fridge. And it just works wonderfully. Don't ask why I forgot this one here, because I don't know. See, I still have a lot of water coming out of this thing. The breeze feels wonderful. Heaven is going to be full of the most fragrant fresh air, the smell of flowers and blooms, nice cool breezes, the warmth of the S-O-N, because the Son of God is going to be our sunshine up there. It's going to be so wonderful in heaven. It's not like I want to die, but I do look forward to it. Alrighty. I have no idea if this is the color they're supposed to be. you know me, I just color stuff any way that I just think of in my head. Okay, I'm going to use a little bit of green down here, which I guess it'd be like a lily pad or something down here. I'm not sure. And I can't tell if that's the rain from the water or if it's the plant. I'm going to color this green first here, and then I'm going to go over it with the blue because it would have water over it. And so the blue being the water would be over it. Okay, so that's the heavenly blue. Grass cutting day over here. Alright, so I think that's enough. Now I can do the little bit of pink. Like I said, I'm not really sure what color any of these are in real life. Oh, I got a little too much there. Try to get that up for a minute. Wet it and then soak it up. That's the only way I know of to try to remove a color. Okay, and then I'm going to just go back over it with a little bit more yellow. Hard blue down on the floor. I have tape on the back of this, so I'm going to go ahead and take it off. And I have a lot of the Stacy tape, the Scrapbooking Made Simple. It's their brand of tape, and we call it Stacy tape because Stacy Park, who is the owner, she designed, had a tape company make this tape, so it's comparable to the, is it Sukuniko tape? One of those most popular tapes for crafting. It's one of those Japanese brands, and I always want to buy American when I can. can. But I didn't have to buy this. I actually won this. I don't remember what kind of drawing she did last year, but I won 3 different things of tape. I won the 1-inch, the 1/2-inch, and the 1/4-inch width of her tapes. And then I'm going to pop this one up a little bit. Try to be frugal with how much I use of something. I try not to use too much. Okay. Alrighty. Now I'm just trying to look to see if there's anything else that I need, which obviously it's really plain right now. It's very blah. And I want to stamp happy birthday. I'm going to do it in the blue. Do I just want to stamp or do I want to emboss it too? I want to find the embossing powder that actually... Maybe it's the white pearls because it's translucent. I'm going to use this one. That means I need to pull out my Misty. So that it gets stamped with the ink and with the embossing ink. So I'm going to close this up while I try to get this real quick. Which means I need to do this first. I think I'll do the happy birthday up here. I have to take my stamp off. And before I put it on there, I have to actually check it. You can see it's kind of goopy. It's been used. It's one that I bought used. It's going to look really plain here. Green ink on there. I need to clean up. Okay, so now heavenly blue. wash it off with a little bit of water. And this one is White Pearls Translucent from Stampin' Stuff. I just want to check and make sure there's nothing in the place where I don't want it. And then heat it up. As you can see, this is a little off, so what I'm going to do is make a creative card. Okay, I'm back. You remember that the card looked like this, and I had embossed Happy Birthday up here, but I cut it down, and I'm going to change the orientation of the car, or the card, so that it goes this direction, because I like this much better. And then I have a happy birthday, and I used some washi tape to hold it in place, and it kind of tore, so I'm gonna have to put a little gem to make it happy up there. I'm trying to find a little pretty to go there. This color. It's getting dark outside, so I can't see as clear now. This color seems to go. I'm still not sure about that. No. Looks to be too big for that area. These yellow ones are a little too yellow. Sometimes it's just not really easy to find what you want. Maybe these will work. And I find that these snips work better for cutting in between. Oh, hold on. Sorry about that. Got dinner reheating in the rice cooker. I always find these are really difficult to cut and separate where you don't accidentally cut one of these. My rice cooker is telling me it's ready. These can actually be cut into, and that's what I'm trying to avoid. I don't want to cut into. And this does not have anything sticky on the back. They're supposed to be soft stick, but these aren't sticking. Okay, so that means I gotta pull out the glue. And I'm only gonna use three. It's not easy to lay this down the way that I want to. Need to put some dimension. So that's something that's a little bit different. I'm going to adhere this down. like I said, I'm not going to bother with the one in the middle. Just do the ones on the outer ends. They will hold it in place, and the middle one, it will hold it up so it won't be crushed in the middle. Okay, I want to put some sparkly on here. So that means some glitter paint. This one is a metallic. It's not really a glitter paint. I'm not really sure how this one would look. I'm going to use this one, paint over the center. I should put the top on the glue, huh? And then I'm going to use some of the gold glitter dust for the yellow. The glitter, it doesn't move exactly the same all over when you paint, and so if you want to get a somewhat consistent layer, you have to pay attention and move the paint around and then add more to the places where it's needed when it doesn't move. I think this gold glitter really kind of brings this to life, makes it really pop. And then I want to paint over these little sparkly, the gems, just so that they will match. And they will look kind of funky at first, but after a while they will be all glittery. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the card, the second card for the day. These will dry in a little bit and they'll look much better. I would like to do something on the sides, but this is going to just be left plain, so it's a nice, easy card for today. Just let me know what you think. Give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment. Have a blessed day. I appreciate you guys taking the time to watch and leave me a comment.